What's up internet, I'm Manish and in this Oracle Database video, I'm going to show you how to work on Oracle Database 11g or 10g using SQL Developer. Now what SQL Developer is? SQL Developer is an IDE, integrated development environment, or we say a graphical tool for database development provided by Oracle itself. The IDE is written in Java language and generally don't require any installation. To know more about SQL Developer, you can read this Oracle blog. The link of this blog is in the video description below. One more important thing, guys, SQL Developer required JDK 1.7 or later. Does make sure you have JDK installed on your system. To download JDK, you can go to this link, this website, and download JDK from here. Don't worry, the link is in the description below. You can get it from there. Okay, to work with SQL Developer, we need to download it. So just open up your browser and go to oracle.com. Then go to download, and in the developer tools section, just click SQL Developer. After doing that, you will be here. Here, first of all, you need to accept the license agreement. Just click it and accept it and choose the appropriate version of SQL Developer. It depends upon the system or the operating system of your machine. I'm working on Windows 7 64-bit. I'm going to download this file. It's around 224 MB. If you don't have JDK installed, you can download this file also, or you can download JDK individually from here. Okay, I have already downloaded this file for you. This must be in my directory, download directory. Here it is. As you can see, it's a zip file, compressed file. We need to uncompress it and zip it. Just right click and extract here. I have already extracted here. This is what we get after unzipping this file. Okay, now just copy this folder and move this folder to your Oracle home directory. And where you'll find the Oracle home directory, just go to your root directory. My root directory is C. Then go to app and just paste it here. It may take one or maybe less minutes. Okay, now just open this folder, and in this folder you'll get sqldeveloper.exe. This is the file which we require. So as we are going to work with this SQL Developer on everyday basis, so it will be better if we make a shortcut of this file on the desktop. So right click it, choose send to, and send it to desktop. And here is our SQL Developer shortcut. Just open it by clicking it, double click it. And here we are. It's okay, fine. To work with our database, first of all, we need to make a connection. To make a connection with our database, just click this green plus button. After doing that, you'll get this window. In the connection name, you can give whatever you want. Like, I'm going to give MySQL. In the username, you need to supply the username. If you remember, we unlocked three users, sys, system, and HR during the installation. If you haven't watched my installation video, just go back and check it out, my database playlist. You'll get how to unlock these usernames. So here we are going to connect with our user HR, and the password for my HR user is HR only. Save this password, otherwise it's gonna ask you for the password again every time you connect to this user. In the hostname, if the database is installed on the same machine over which you have this SQL Developer, then just don't mess with this. Let it be localhost. But if the database is installed on some other machine, then you need to supply the IP address of that machine here. That we will see how to connect with the server in the future video. Port ID is 1521. This is the default port for our database. In the SID, this is the important thing here. SID is a unique identifier for your database. Whenever you are going to make a database, you're gonna provide a unique name, which is a global database name. That's our SID. If you remember during the installation, the global database name of our database is ORCL, or if I say there is only one database I have made here by the name of ORCL. So I'm gonna put ORCL here. Sorry, ORCL. And after that, just it will be better if we test whether we're gonna connect it or not. If something is wrong here, then we're gonna get a red color error message here, but it as it is showing success, it means everything is fine. Just click connect, and here we are. This is our worksheet where we're gonna put our every query and try to execute it. For this video purpose, what I'm going to do, I'm gonna show you the user. For doing so, just write as show user terminator. And to execute the query, either you can click this play button, you're gonna get your result of this query here in this output window, or if you are a fan of keyboard shortcut like me, then you can do control and enter. You can press control and enter to execute it. After doing that, you'll get the answer here. Everything is same. That's it for today, guys. Hope you like it. Thanks for liking, commenting, sharing, and watching more of our videos.